Bonjour les amis et bienvenue. Aujourd'hui nous allons continuer d'où nous nous sommes arrêtés la dernière semaine. Je m'appelle Madame Estelle et j'espère que vous allez très bien. Welcome friends, today we are going to continue where we stopped. My name is Mrs. Esther and I hope you are all fine. Okay, last time we talked about exprimer la gratitude for my grateful pupils, and today we are going to continue from where we stopped. As a way of reminder, last time we talked about how to express gratitude and we looked at some keywords, how to respond when you are or when someone is expressing gratitude to you, how you are going to respond. We looked at merci, we looked also at merci beaucoup, and we looked at the responses. Someone might say de rien, which means you are welcome, and someone might also say je t'en prie, which also means you are welcome. Okay, without wasting time today, we are going to continue from there. Specifically today, we are going to look at how a friend will appreciate some other friend, for instance, when giving a gift, now writing back to the friend, appreciating the person for the gift or expressing gratitude for the gift received. And also a student appreciating the master, the school teacher, for the encouragement and the classes that he or she has received so far from the teacher. And we are also going to look at those words that are used in these write-ups today. That's what we are going to be looking at. So now that you know that expressing gratitude in French, you say merci ou bien merci beaucoup. And then, so when someone says de rien, you don't have to be confused. You know it means you are welcome. Someone may say it means don't mention. So it means you are welcome. And if the person does not say de rien, you might hear je t'en prie. So that means also you are welcome. And someone might say it means please. So, in this topic for expressing gratitude, it means you are welcome. In some other context, it can mean please. Okay, we're going to be looking at the write-up. We're going to look at two. The first one, the appreciation for the gift received, and then the second one will be the letter.
Okay, so this is leave. Leave means read, as you can see here in the bracket. So we are going to read this write-up in the form of a small letter. So this is a letter of appreciation. You can see what I've underlined here. That is the focus for this topic. So we are going to look at it and then I will explain what I've underlined. This is Mamadou. This writer is writing to, and the writer of this letter, this short letter, is Fatou. Okay, let's read. Merci, Mamadou. Okay, so you have seen merci, so you also know that it is the writer is expressing gratitude to Mamadou. That's why he's saying merci. Merci, Mamadou. Je te remercie pour les cadeaux. Je te remercie, like I've underlined here. Je te remercie means I thank you. I thank you. Okay, so that's another way of expressing gratitude. Je te remercie. Pour les cadeaux here means these gifts that you can see here that I'm pointing at right now. So this gift in French called le cadeau. Thank you for the gift. I thank you for the gift. That means je te remercie pour le cadeau qui m'ont fait grand plaisir. Qui m'ont fait grand plaisir. I thank you for the gift that made me very, very happy. Gros bees. Very short letter. Gros bees. Gros bees. Big kisses. Big kisses. Fatou. Okay, that is the writer of the letter, Fatou, writing to Mamadou, appreciating him for these gifts he has received from him. Okay, so we are going to also look at... Okay, so from what we have read so far, this is exercise arm. Exercise arm. So these are questions from the above write-up that we just read. Number one says, qui a écrit ce mot? Qui a écrit ce mot? Who wrote this word? What we just read up there. Qui a écrit ce mot? Who wrote this word? Number two. That you are going to provide the answers to this. Number two, aki. Aki. Aki means to who. To who. So, who wrote the letter? Number one, to who. Number two. Number three, pourquoi. Pourquoi means why. So, you're going to tell us why the letter is was written. Number four, pouvez-vous faire un mot barrel? Pouvez-vous faire un mot pareil? Can you write a word like this? So if you are asked to write a short write-up like what we just read, can you? No, who, we. Yes or no? Okay.
Now, je te remercie is another way of appreciating gratitude, like what you just saw on the text. Now, the writer started with merci, Mamadou, and said, je te remercie pour le cadeau qui m'a fait grand plaisir. Je te remercie, merci. So, you have now seen another way of expressing gratitude. And don't forget the way he ended it, say, gros bees. That's big kisses. So know how to, in case you are asked to write something like that, know how to start and know where to end. Right now, we are going to look at another letter that is a bit longer than what we just looked at. We're going to look at how to also express gratitude.
Okay, this is the second letter. The second letter you can also see li, so that means we are going to read. Okay, this letter, the writer's address is Lagos, like you can see here, and it was written on the 23rd day of May 2014. Okay, let's start. Cher Metro. Cher maître, that's dear master or dear teacher. Je souhaite vous exprimer ma sincère gratitude pour tous vos conseils et vos encouragements. Now, look at what I've underlined. I've underlined je souhaite vous exprimer ma sincère gratitude écoutez vos conseils et vos encouragements. Ok. Now, the writer of this letter is simply saying she wishes to express her sincere gratitude to the teacher for all her counsels, that is advice and encouragement. This is advice, and this encouragement means encouragement. Now, merci pour votre dernier coup. Okay, here she has expressed gratitude in another way. Right here, she is also expressing gratitude in another way. So you have seen merci coming into play again. So, in other words, merci is basic for expressing gratitude. What do I mean by that? Merci here is the one of the first words any learner can come across when expressing gratitude. Merci. Merci. One I'm pointing at right now. Okay. Merci pour votre dernier cours de calcul. Vous expliquez bien. Vous expliquez bien. Okay. You see, thank you for your last class, calculation class. You explained well. Here again, I underlined to say grande merci. Grande merci means a big thank you. A big thank you. And who is the writer of this letter? Angela. Angela is writing to the school teacher or master for all the counsels, encouragement, and the classes. Okay, let's go back to this letter again. I said this, the address of the writer here is Lagos, and the date this letter was written was le 23 mai 2014. Le 23 mai 2014. Cher maître, je souhaite vous exprimer ma sincère gratitude pour tous vos conseils et vos encouragements. Merci pour votre dernier cours de calcul. Vous expliquez bien. Grande merci. Grande merci. Okay. This is another way of expressing gratitude, and this is also another way of expressing gratitude. Okay, so remember we read that first write-up, and the exercise on is for you to provide answers for. So for the second one we just read, there is exercise though for you to provide answers to those questions for me, and then we are going to look at it right now. Now, exercice on quand a été écrit la lettre? Quand? When was the letter written? When was the letter written? Though, Qui a écrit? Who wrote the letter? Pourquoi? You know what pourquoi means? And pourquoi? There are two reasons why the letter was written, the second letter. So you have to state the two reasons. That's why you have pourquoi two times here on this exercise though. So that's what I'm expecting to get from you this week.
Okay, so this brings us to the end of today's lesson, and here Madame Esther has to say au revoir.